So I wanted to create this short video to talk about at what blood sugar level does a person start to notice organ damage? Okay, because it's important, especially if you are a diabetic or you're a pre-diabetic or you have insulin resistance. And by the way, I would say that at least 70% of the population has insulin resistance and they're headed to diabetes. So this is a very important topic. Now, the ADA, American Diabetes Association, the experts in diabetes, say that your A1C, which is an average blood sugars of 3 months, should be below 7.4, okay? Now, if we convert this to blood sugars, that's a blood sugar of 166, okay? That is way, way too high because the damage starts to occur when it gets over 100. Now, one study, which I'll put a link down below, indicated that fasting blood glucose levels at between 110 and 125 already created a loss of 40% of the beta cells of the pancreas. The beta cells are the cells in the pancreas that produce insulin. The more the beta cell becomes destroyed, the less insulin you have, the higher the blood sugar, the more you have glucose toxicity, and the more damage you're going to experience. Now, the ideal scene for an A1C would be less than 5, okay? It's 5%, not 7.4. It's way too high. It's definitely common knowledge that you need to avoid added sugars, but realize that fruit has a lot of sugar, starches have a lot of sugar, and so do whole grains. So this could be part of the problem right there. Diabetics in general already lost over 50% of their beta cells, and that's why they're diabetic, because diabetes is defined as high blood glucose. Okay, why? Because insulin is not there to push it down, and just before that we have insulin resistance, so that's creating a much higher output of insulin over a long period of time, which insulin itself is toxic to the tissues. Now we have a situation with high glucose toxicity and high insulin toxicity. Not good, but it's very easy to solve. All you have to do is cut out the refined carbs and the sugars and do intermittent fasting. And the good news about this is that you can reverse the damage, okay, if you get it in time. So that's the good news, but you have to get it in time. All right, thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back.
With another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple.
We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.